it's quite amazing to me that actually sci-fi is capturing so much earlier and is using nomenclature that then we adopt in science. We could name teleportation something else. I mean, we know teleportation from Star Trek, right? Beam me up, Scotty. That's not what we are doing here.
All right, you mutinous, disloyal, computerized half-breed. We'll see about you deserting my ship.
Since the puppy is complaining, this is Cubit, and he arrived home a few days ago. So if you hear cooing and willing, this is him. With quantum teleportation and networks of quantum devices, we can achieve progress both in scientific exploration, in matters of fundamental physics, but also we can develop the so-called quantum internet, which is being seen as an application that would ensure much more secure communications than the normal internet that we have now. We envisioned that we could build systems in order to put at work the experimental demonstrations that we had from 20 years ago and have systems engineering and systems integration so that we can actually present a prototype of a quantum internet. When we talk about quantum, we mean very precise, right? So once you arrive at very precise measurements beyond the classical precision, let's say, that we can achieve with devices that have been developed in the 20th century, then you are arriving in the quantum realm. So quantum imaging for medicine might be one of the first and most important applications. You can have magnetometers, quantum magnetometers inside the cells that do mapping and bio, get information in vivo and imaging in vivo with quantum imaging that is unprecedented. And it will be a revolution, but it, adiabatically, you will start using it without even knowing it. I mean, you're not going to have a quantum computer on your desk, but maybe when you log in on your bank, there would be some quantum encryption system so that and there's no intercepts and nobody can get your information. But first, we have to build quantum computers. In other words, there is a direct path of thinking, well, computers today, they have so many transistors in a small chip that now we are reaching at the atomic level or the quantum level of how we build them. And the power is huge that they consume. And so you have to find other ways to do computation. So that's a straightforward argument of an application that you can map from the past on how we're going to use all these quantum systems in the future. Years ago, we didn't predict that you could have this propagation of misinformation on the internet at this level where society is formed now based on the information there. And so if you imagine quantum information, that it is a superposition of a lot of information, then one can sit down and think about the societal impact. And there are people who are making proposals in order to bring also these other disciplines together in order to think this through. in the history of the development of science and technology, we had to think about the power of nuclear physics, not just as an experiment where we write a scientific paper, but how it's used. Same thing with the Human Genome Project, and now with the CRISPR, and same thing with artificial intelligence. There is an unfiltered, unthought through way of how much of the technology is needed, for what reasons, whether we use frivolously technology. In other words, if I want to have an AI and call a drone to bring me a cup of coffee, is this something that we really need, or is this frivolous use of a lot of tools that we have developed with science and technology? And as we are in the 21st century, after the incredible renaissance of science and technology of the 20th century, considering all the human civilization and how we developed, I think it's important to think through the impact on humanity so that we don't proceed on paths that can bring us in trouble, and every step of the way we take it for granted that it should be that way.